Hello and welcome to New Frontiers on CCTV International. I'm Ji Xiaojun in Beijing. In the early spring of 1977, a farmer from the village of Piligang in Henan Province made a discovery that would have far-reaching consequences for the study of Chinese history. The object Li Tiedan found was nothing special to look at, just a heavy stone slab. But it would turn out to be one of the most important archaeological finds made in China in the 20th century. It would lead to the history of the country's agricultural civilization being dated back a further 1,000 years. And it would also make Piligang, the village where Li Tiedan's family had been living for generations, famous.
When Li Tiedan turned up at the county's cultural center gasping for breath with the heavy sack on his shoulder on April 2, 1977, the short-term archaeology training class was still underway. At the time, Xu Wen San was lecturing in the classroom. He remembers that day very clearly. As he carefully removed the saddle churn and roller from the sack and placed them on the desk, Xu Wen San asked the young farmer where he had found them. The millstone with its unique shape caught the attention of everyone present. The staff of the culture center approached the saddle churn and roller and began to examine them. Li Tiedan, exhausted and sweating profusely, sat to one side. But he was happy and he had a big smile on his face. From the expressions on the faces of the specialists in the room, he knew he had done something that would bring honor to his clan.
I felt very happy. 就是过去群众对这保护文物任人犹在认识不够，对文物的重要意义没有认识到。说通过上一次在他的村东南地给群众宣传文物法、文物的意义、保护文物的重要性、保护文物任人犹在这等等这些内容以后，群众的觉悟大大提高啊。 他对文物非常重视，说这样子他把出土的东西给我送来。说担心的是什么呢？我当时我给他交代就是，发现文物的原地不动，立即上报。这他发现文物以后，他把文物取出来送来了，这肯定现场会有损坏，说担心的是这样。
Early the next morning, Xu Wen San, Li Youmo, and Zhao Shigang rode borrowed bicycles to the site in Piligang village where the artifacts had been unearthed. While there, they came to the conclusion that the area west of Piligang village was an important site of a very ancient culture.
We went there and looked. There was nothing, no one. 我用小刺儿就给它慢慢剥开，这一剥嘞，给人的头剥出来，头骨剥出来，这眼窝剥出来，鼻子剥出来了，嘴剥出来了，这我们感到这个，但是这脸上、头上、嘴那都长得跟大金子獠牙似的。这又往左边一剥嘞，出土了一截的陶罐。 往右边一眼呢，又是一间陶器。这证明是又一座墓葬。这就赶快把它封好。封好了，我立即给佩里岗南队的张队长说：“我说这些文物出土的很重要，这些地方暂时不要平整土地。我回去立即给地区汇报以后，看看决定咋办。拒不停工，暂时停工。”
It was a discovery of major significance. After Xue Wenzhan returned to the cultural center, he immediately called Cui Gang, a senior official of the Cultural Bureau of Kaifeng Prefecture, and told him about the discovery of the millstone. On April the 8th, 1977, Cui Gong, who was responsible for the short-term archaeology training class for local villagers, put Zhao Shigang in charge of a team made up of class participants. Their task would be to carry out a trial excavation at the site in Peiligang village. Unfortunately, due to a lack of funds, only a few people participated in the trial excavation, and it lasted only a short time. Zhao Shigang led the training class participants to Peiligang village. To everyone's dismay, however, the spot where Li Tiedan had discovered the millstone had been completely leveled. The area would have to be surveyed. The decision was made to dig an exploration ditch along the western part of an irrigation channel where the land had not been touched. The purpose was clear. The team was working to unravel the mysteries surrounding the millstone. The aim was to find out when it was made, what it had been used for, work out its relationship with pottery objects found in the same area, and determine which archaeological period the area belonged to. Zhao Shigang suspected that there might be other important objects or traces in the earth beneath the spot where the millstone was found. He and his trainees decided to dig a square pit at the spot where Li Tiedan had found the millstone in the hope of uncovering more artifacts. The members of the team worked hour after hour, layer after layer, scraping the earth with small spades. But after an entire day, nothing was revealed at the spot Li Tiedan had said he'd found the millstone. Zhao Shigang felt dejected.
But Zhao Shigang refused to give up. He enlarged the area of the search around the spot pinpointed by Li Tiedan. Before long, between 10 and 20 meters away, they came upon a square pit.
就是有个方坑，然后把那浮土去掉以后，就发现有这个石磨盘的那个取出来的那个窝痕迹，就是取出来那个痕迹，还有一些陶壶啊，还有一些陶罐啊，这些东西。
But were these really the indentations left after Li Tiedan removed the stone saddle churn and stone roller? Zhao Shigang sent his trainees to fetch the millstone Li Tiedan had delivered to the county's cultural center. He then lowered it carefully into the indentation. Slowly, the millstone was lowered into position. Both the saddle churn and roller fitted into the depressions in the earth perfectly. Zhao Shugang was now certain that Li Tiedan had taken the millstone from the earth at this very spot.
这一点是定的，这一点，这是一点，第二点在定制的时候，就连石磨盘跟这个墓里边发现的陶器、陶罐啊，是那个钵呀，还有那个石菜啊、石斧呀，都是同时的，因为它在一个墓里边发现的，那它这个时代应该是一致的，应该是一致的。这样子就把这个陶这石磨盘的它这个证明出土的，在那有哪些工程的东西，这个问题解决了。Zhao
Shugang located the tomb that had once contained the millstone some 20 meters to the south of the spot Li Tiedan had found the millstone. Everyone present was jubilant. A search that had taken several years had not been undertaken in vain. The shards of pottery unearthed were all handmade, and there were only two types. One type was a kind of sandy brown pottery, and the other kind was made of clay. They were unevenly fashioned and were obviously quite different from the coloured pottery objects unearthed from the ruins in Tanghu village and from other sites of Yang Shao culture. In short, the pottery objects found in Peiligang village were much more primitive. Were they the cultural remains of the Neolithic age that specialists had long been seeking? Were they even older than Yang Shao culture? No one could be certain. The first trial excavation at the site of Peiligang culture lasted only a short time from April the 8th to April the 21st, 1977, and it covered only a small area. A much larger excavation would be needed to acquire a comprehensive view of this important historical site. But while the first trial excavation had been limited, it had yielded a breakthrough. The original source of the millstone had been located, and the site of a previously unknown ancient culture had been discovered. It was now known as Peiligang culture. What impact would the discovery of this millstone exert on the study of the Neolithic age in China? What had the millstone been used for? And what had life been like for the people who had used it? Shortly after the first trial excavation was completed, the cultural center of Xinjiang County set up a training class for the county's residents to introduce them to the basics of archaeology. The class lasted from April the 20th to the end of May of 1977. The participants in the class photographed, drew pictures of, and even restored objects unearthed at the site of Peiligang culture. Cui Gang, a government official in charge of the Cultural Relics Administration Committees of Kaifeng Prefecture and Xinjiang County, asked Zhao Shugang to compile a brief report about the trial excavation of the site of Peiligang culture. Zhao Shugang committed himself fully to the task of sorting through the data obtained from the Peiligang culture site. Zhao Shugang and his colleagues were eager to uncover the secrets of the ancient millstone discovered at the site. They knew that the discovery of Peiligang culture was very important because it provided a rare opportunity to trace the source of Yang Shao culture, which had been discovered earlier in the century. In April 1921, Johan Gunnar Andersen, a Swedish geologist, discovered a Neolithic Age site in Yang Shao village in Mianchu County, Henan Province. The civilization the site represented was named Yang Shao Culture. Before the discovery of the Yang Shao Culture site, many scholars in the West had not considered the possibility of China having ever had a Stone Age culture of its own. They had assumed that Chinese civilization had evolved from some culture in the West. One Western scholar had even said, information from abroad was a decisive factor in the discovery of the existence of the Neolithic Age in China. After Anderson's discovery of Yang Shao culture, Western scholars still held that Yang Shao culture was most likely some kind of extension of a culture from the West. The basis of their argument was that there was no link between Yang Shao culture and any earlier culture. The colored pottery ware found in Gansu province was more advanced than that found in Henan province, and this, they said, upheld their argument that Yang Shao culture was introduced to China from the West. This statement had long been repudiated by specialists in later periods, but they had failed to uncover any remains from the Neolithic Age that could be confirmed as being from a period earlier than those found at the sites of Yang Shao culture on the Central Plain. This meant that the source of Yang Shao culture had not been located. Zhao Shigang decided that coming up with some kind of definition of the nature of Peiligang culture should be a top priority in his report about the trial excavation in Peiligang village. It seemed to him that everything found at the site bore marks of an earlier archaeological period.
在这个整理中间，我都发现所发现的这些东西，面壁的石磨盘啊、石磨榜啊、这个石灿啊、石斧啊、桃壶啊这些东西，是我以前都没有见过的东西。就是说呢，在以前的这个所发现的仰韶文化、钮山文化，然后商周这个时间的这些发现的陶器都没有这个东西，就考虑到。
Since the Peiligang site and its cultural features was so dissimilar from the Yang Shao and Longshan sites, it seemed possible that it belonged to a previously unknown culture. And if that was the case, what archaeological period did it belong to?
The Peiligang site is very close to the sites of Yang Shao culture and Longshan culture. But the cultural features of the three are completely different from one another, and it is clear that the differences are not a result of their different locations. The cultures must have existed in different archaeological periods. But if this is the case, which culture is the earlier culture?
一个就是说它这个陶器制作的是比较原始，因为陶器的它这个都比较那个烧制的温度比较低，这个是比这个燃烧文化那个都容易碎，这是指烧陶器的比较原始的一种规律吧，一种规律。另外就是这个陶器上陶器的这个它有个性质啊。 一个性质的变化的一个规律，一个规律，这个在以前有好多专家们的这个已经做出来一个它这个变化的规律，变化规律，这样子的话，它就是它就比这个都比这个仰韶文化和龙山文化都比较原始。
Zhao Shigang and his colleagues worked day and night searching for information that could illuminate the newly discovered culture by checking reference materials and restoring broken artifacts. But by this time, a number of scholars were already putting forward different viewpoints about the nature of Peiligang culture.
少数民族，北方少数民族南下的遗留是这样一个观点，就是说呢，是北方那个尤其是红山文化呀、啊，或者和其他这文化的一致吧，然后南下到河南。 在这住，然后留下来的佩里岗遗址。
The new viewpoints made Zhao Shigang look into the matter again. After repeated comparisons and analyses, he came to the conclusion that there were clear differences between the artifacts of Pei Li Gang culture and those left behind by the ethnic minority people from the north. They belonged to different cultures. In other words, Pei Li Gang culture was not developed by the ethnic minority people from the north. It was an entirely separate culture. Having gained a clear idea about the nature of Pei Li Gang culture, Zhao Shigang spent a month writing a brief report on the excavation. In late May, he finished his report and gave it the title Investigation and Trial Excavation at the Pei Li Gang Site in Xinjiang County, Hunan Province. Zhao Shigang wrote in his report, "We believe that the Pei Li Gang site belongs to another culture, one independent from all the Neolithic Age cultures found so far. For the time being, we're calling it Pei Li Gang culture." The Cultural Relics Bureau of Hunan Province sent the objects unearthed in Pei Li Gang village to Beijing. This was done so that specialists there could work on identifying the archaeological period of Pei Li Gang culture as quickly as possible. In June 1977, Cui Gang, Li Youmo, and Xue Wentan went to Beijing to brief specialists of the State Bureau of Cultural Relics. The specialists recognized the discovery as an important one and asked that the artifacts be taken to the Institute of Archaeology under the Chinese Academy of Social Sciences for laboratory testing. An Jermin, director of the Neolithic section of the Institute of Archaeology, examined the specimen from Pei Li Gang village and read the brief report Cui Gang and his colleagues had brought with them. He felt immediately that the discovery was indeed very important, and he reported the find to Xia Nai, the director of the institute. When An Jermin told Xia Nai the news, the director of the institute was presiding over a meeting. Recognizing the importance of the discovery, he immediately left the meeting to meet with Cui Gang and his colleagues.
Xia Nai 所长轻易不说话，最后他说了两句，一句就是“新苗头很值得重视”，就说了两句。他一说这新苗头很值得重视，我们就感到比较重要啊。他又问，他说你们发掘当中采集的木炭带来吗？我说带来了，带来他夏所长立即通知他呢，说的实验室的同志去把木炭标本采拿走，拿走交代他赶快采样年代。
While in Beijing, they also visited the famous archaeologist Su Bingqi. This great authority in the field examined the specimen and gave his opinion.
苏炳新先生看到我们带的东西一摸，他说这东西至少在7000年以前，真不愧为是专家了，一看就知道是7000年以前。他说这是你咱们中国第一次出土见到这样早期的东西。他说我写信给你们带回去，给你们这个河南省文物局文物处处长傅业华同志，叫他特别重视这个遗址，要支持发掘。
This initial expert appraisal was encouraging. However, if the true significance of the Pei Li Gang site was ever to be revealed, a much larger excavation would be needed. On April the 12th, 1978, a second excavation at Pei Li Gang village began, involving the relevant officers of the Kaifeng and Xinjiang governments and archaeologists from the History Department of Zhengzhou University. We'll hear all about what they found in our next episode. Please join us then. Thank you for staying with us on New Frontiers. I'm Ji Xiaojun on CCTV International. See you next time.